This dodecahedral cage is made of silica, and it's tiny, really tiny. It was created by researchers in the States who hope that one day it could help in the fight against cancer. To give you a sense of just how small this nanocage is, let's start with a single grain of salt. It's around 300 microns wide. Compare that to, say, a red blood cell. That's it there. Now, compare the red blood cell to something much smaller, like this, the HIV virus. The silica nanocage is a bit more than 10 times smaller than that. To make it, researchers use a relatively simple technique. First, they need a template. For that, they use soap molecules. When in solution, the soap molecules form tiny balls called micelles. The size of the micelles is precisely controlled by the researchers. Then they add a silica precursor to the mix. Gradually, the negatively charged silica precursors are attracted to the positively charged micelle template. Over time, they build up, forming the structure. The template could then be washed or burned out, which would leave a perfect dodecahedral cage. What's more, this process happens without any intervention. It's self-assembling. This is how the researchers think that the cages form, but until recently, they didn't even know they existed. They're so small, it's nearly impossible to snap a picture of them. To get that glimpse of the nanocages, researchers used cryo-electron microscopy. They put their sample on a tiny disc and plunge it into liquid nitrogen, flash freezing it. Then they can use an electron microscope to take a peek, making images that look a bit like this. They repeated the process over and over to gather nearly 20,000 images of the fuzzy-looking cages, all lying in slightly different positions, at different angles and orientations. Now, here's the clever bit. A computer can analyze and average out all the different images of all the different orientations of the structure. So feed them into a computer, and an algorithm can reconstruct a 3D representation. And what popped out was a perfect dodecahedron, only 11 nanometers across. Studies have shown that ultra-small silica particles can easily and safely pass through the body, being excreted in the urine rather than getting stuck in the liver, which can cause side effects. Perhaps nanocages like these could be used as containers for things like anti-cancer drugs, or as ultra-small vehicles to carry diagnostic molecules. But that is still a long way off.